What's going on, rock stars? Welcome back to another episode of The 1% Life. I'm your host, peak performance coach and trainer, Joanie Dillon. Today, we're talking about the key to creating a compelling future. So if you're listening to us live, first of all, on Facebook, welcome in. Drop a hashtag live. If it's your first time listening, put a one in the comments. If you are a repeat listener, and put a two in the comments. And if you're listening to the replay, of course, we want to know that too. Drop a hashtag replay. So rock stars, we're talking about how to create a compelling future. Why is this important to you? And what you may be doing that is not helping you to create that compelling future, which is the life that you desire at some level and the one that you actually want to live, creating your 1% life. So when we think about creating a compelling future, you know, I'm running this challenge, the Create Your 1% Life Challenge right now. And I remember back on day one where we were really talking about what does that compelling future look like for you? What does it mean to create your 1% life? And what specifically does a day in this life look like for you, your perfect day? And a couple of the people had responded, like, I can't go there. I can't allow myself to see it. Like, they just were disconnected from that compelling future. And here's what I believe the problem is that we as a society, and I'm making a massive generalization right now, rock stars, and so maybe this is not you, and I want to know if you're somebody who actually does the opposite of this, but I feel like we've been conditioned to just be like, you know, in our stuff, right? Like we're in our stuff, like we're working through it, and this is just the life that I have, and maybe there'll be small minor tweaks or changes, but nothing majorly different, right? Who can relate? Like, you know, maybe you have these hope and dreams, but are you connected to those hopes and dreams? Do you believe they can happen? So the problem is that when we do not allow ourselves the creative space to dream, then we can't create a compelling future because we're not even accessing the space that allows us to create that compelling future. Maybe you know what I'm talking about. So what has to happen in order to create this life that's compelling, that pulls you toward it, is that you actually have to spend time, make time to dream. So a couple of weeks ago, I was talking to one of my coaching clients in the mastermind I lead called the 1%, which are industry top 1%. And females who, you know, are just doing awesome things in their life and always ready and hungry for the next level. And one of my clients was feeling really disconnected to her goal. She had just gone back to work after 3 months off. And she said, you know, I feel, gosh, what was the words that she used? She said it wasn't disconnect, but it was, you know, like it was just deflated. It was, there was a total disconnect to her goal. She was like, you know, not alive. It did not, when she thought about her goal, it did not make her come alive, right? And her goal was actually, I said, okay, so let's attach, aside from the money goal, right? When you sell this amount, that's going to allow you to achieve this income or get this income. What does that do for you, right? We have to get connected to the why. Why do we want this thing in our life? And, you know, what we realized, she said, well, when I do that, it'll allow me to help my husband buy this manufacturing warehouse. I think it was actually a warehouse, not a manufacturing facility, but a warehouse, which will help the business and all this stuff. And so I'm like, okay, well, is this your goal or is this a goal for your husband? And she said, well, I think it's my goal, but here's what really had not yet happened until after this call. They hadn't been connecting together to dream together. They hadn't been dreaming together about what's important to you, babe, what's important to me, and how can we create this vision together? Maybe we don't have a vision. Maybe we're so disconnected right now and our, you know, you're doing your silo of whatever it is that you're doing, and you know, your partner's doing their silo. And in this situation, there was definitely some of that going on. And then what happens is that there's just this disconnect, right? Why are we each doing what we're doing? Is it for a common goal, a common purpose? And if we can make a common goal and common purpose that we're moving towards together, can you imagine how much more quickly you'll get there? Way quicker, right? So that week she set up, I think they had spent 3 times dreaming. Like they went out and met at a restaurant. They just literally connected from the kids, 4 kids. You know how that can be when you're raising children. And they said, okay, let's dream. And so they got on the same page. And that is so powerful. Now, I'm not speaking specifically in terms of just relationship. I think it's an incredible thing to do with your partner. My partner and I, we dream together now, and it's so fun. Because prior to him coming into my life, I realized I was so focused on just growing my business and creating an impact in the world that reached, you know, millions of people. But I wasn't saying, for what purpose am I doing this? How will this, yes, this will benefit them, but how will it benefit me? What is the life that I am wanting to create? And to go beyond the boundaries of what felt acceptable and okay, right? Like, yeah, I can see that happening. But what if we were to go way beyond the boundaries of what's acceptable and okay to dream, right? Like, it's just there, it's at the top of your mind. Oh, I can see that happening. What if you were to go way beyond that? How can you get there? So one of the ways that I think we get there is that we intentionally go into this with purpose, purpose and intention, and allow your unconscious mind, your subconscious mind, whatever you want to call it, however you want to refer to it, to allow you to access a place that you have not allowed yourself to access before and to begin to dream. One of the things that really helps me is I go on Pinterest and I start looking at different images in different areas of life. And I look up things like, you know, homes in Montana photography, or land property in Montana photography. And this is how we were, one of the ways that we were able to create our joint vision together, our vision together, was by playing and seeing these images online and getting it more crystallized and more clear. And maybe for you, it's, you know, having an event somewhere in the world and bringing people from all over together. Or maybe it's, you know, a certain boat that you're in the process of manifesting, or that you never allowed yourself to believe it was possible because it's a couple $100,000. What if you were to go out there and find images on Pinterest, download the app Pinterest, or Google them, and add the word photography to it, so you're not getting a bunch of crazy words and images that people are putting out for marketing purposes. And what happens is when you do that and you see a couple or you see an individual that maybe kind of resembles you or looks like you, you start connecting yourself to that image and that vision. And this was really powerful. We started also journaling about, what do we want? What's important to you in this home, in this land that we're buying? And so he would tell me all the things that were important to him. I say, okay, well, here's what's important to me. You know, we have to be this far away from an airport because I'm always traveling, right? And I need to be this close away from the city, which is really now a town, right? And all of the other amenities and things that we wanted to build and create on our property. And we're building a retreat center in Montana. We'll build our home, or we'll buy it when we manifest the right one. The one that we thought we were going to get fell through. Nonetheless, you know, it wasn't the right one for us. So we're creating that vision, and he's like gone into the details of the bathroom and what specifically the tub's going to look like and what's going to be around it and all of these things. Are you allowing yourself to dream, Rockstar? Are you allowing yourself to go beyond what feels comfortable, even if you don't know the how, and especially if you don't know the how? Because if we don't allow ourselves to see that vision of the someday, the possibility of, maybe for you it's multiple homes, you'd love to own a home in Hawaii or in Puerto Rico or somewhere else in the world, or, you know, Cyprus in the Mediterranean, right? Or wherever that is. If you don't allow yourself to go there and you simply base your future on what your current circumstances are now, how will you ever create a compelling future? How will you ever go beyond the limitations that you've set for yourself? You won't, right? And if this is making sense to you, drop a yes in the comments. Like, yes, I get it. And if it's lighting you up, I want to see that as well. So we have to give ourselves permission to dream. And sometimes it's like, it's been so suppressed for so long. Imagine when you were kids and the kids would go out and they would create superheroes, and they'd be, you know, I was making my stuffed animals come to life, and we had this whole, like, I just remember all these fun things that we would do as children, creating these fantasy worlds that we would live in. Where has that gone as adults, right? Why have we suppressed that? And as you get older, your parents maybe have said to you, you know, don't do that. There's no such thing as imaginary friends. And, you know, whatever that is, and it's suppressed your imagination, your creativity. You've literally suppressed it unconsciously as a child. Most people's got suppressed. Very few parents know how to encourage that type of behavior, to put their kids up and say, oh my gosh, I love that you have an imaginary friend. Tell me more about them. Who are they? What are they doing? And, you know, all of that, encouraging that behavior. And so when we get put into a box, even in the education system, right, we call it the miseducation system, unfortunately, because it really suppresses creativity with the current education system, unless you're in some special school. And everybody's fit into a box, like they're forced to be in this box. As adults, we've been disconnected from that, right? We think that there's just systems and there's processes and we got to go to work and then, or go to college maybe and go get a job. And then this job, if it doesn't fall under certain parameters, it's like, then you go find another job. And that's it. You go to work, get up, come home, pay bills. Go to work, get up, come home, pay bills. Every once in a while, you fit in a 3-day or a 5-day or a 7-day vacation. What? That sounds miserable to me, right? Just this last week, I was telling somewhere I was talking about this in my, I think the Create Your 1% Life Challenge, that my partner and I decided, what if we could take 4 months off a year, each of us from our businesses, both of us, and like literally disconnect other than posting on Instagram because we just enjoy, love sharing our life in that way. But other than that, like no trainings, no events, no nothing, just going out, finding time to, you know, further dream, create our compelling future, and get out and travel the world. What if we could do that? What if we could take the last week off of every single month to just focus on us? What if we could do that in the future we're creating and building, and disconnect from the routine of work and business and allow ourselves the space, the creativity to think? So we have to build in this time into our life. Keith Cunningham, who wrote The Road Less Stupid, incredible entrepreneur, he talks about a time called thinking time. And when you can plan in your life, this, even if it's 5 minutes, start with 5 minutes of thinking time a day. Maybe work up to 15 minutes, a half hour, or even an hour. But that time, all distractions turned off, is just your time to think, right? Just your time to think. And maybe you want to pose a question, like, what if anything were possible? What could my life look like for me? Powerful, right? And then set your timer. And I often like to listen to what's called brain.fm, and you can turn on some meditative music, you can turn on some focus music, and just allow yourself to go into a deep alpha state if you do that, and or theta, depending on what you're listening to, and allow yourself to access that place within you that allows for creativity to flow, that allows you to stir up just images in your mind, internal representations in your mind of what's possible for you and your family, or you and yourself and your future family, whatever that is for you. So rock stars, I got a call. I'm a few minutes late for now. I got to get on. So if you got value from today's episode, first of all, drop an emoji. I always like to have the popcorn emojis that you got value at the end. And then get out there and drop a comment, tag somebody in this, tag 3 people, tag 5 people, share this out to your groups and your communities for people who want and need and are craving something positive in their life to be able to get out of the funk, their anxiety, their frustration, and move towards creating their compelling future. I strongly believe that we all have it within us. We don't all have the tools yet. And that just getting access to those tools is so crucial to be able to break through the funk that many people are going through and create your 1% life. Does it happen overnight? Of course not. But you have to make steps towards this. And that's why we personally choose to run what I call the Create Your 1% Life Challenge, to give people the tools to be able to tap into that part of their mind that allows them to dream, that allows them to connect with possibility and to navigate through any times, no matter what's going on in the economy, no matter what's going on in their personal household, to actually get out there and shift the negative thinking into a place of empowerment, purpose, and drive, and just take the action and get it done, because that's what it takes now more than ever. So we're ending a challenge here in the next couple days, but we'll have one coming up in the next couple weeks. You can always go to the1%life.com, the1%life.com, and join us. So rockstars, hope you enjoyed today's episode. Please do us a favor. If you're listening on one of our podcasting platforms, please leave us a 5-star review if you got value from today, and a 5-star rating and review. And we'll see you on tomorrow's episode. Get out there and create an unstoppable day. Peace. Bye, everyone.